because, you know, cutting a 2.5 hour story to 42 minutes, you know, a lot of it was quite painful to do. When I said, okay, let's not put this drama, let's put something else. It was a difficult process first to choose the music. And then to tell the story with a minimalist setting and just props. Yeah, so if you notice, the white rose basically symbolizes the love of, the pure love of Alfredo for Violeta. And the cups, of course, symbolize the high life. The bracelet gift symbolizes the material and financial security that Violeta has in her relationship with the Baron, and that she'll have to give up in order to become exclusively Alfredo's beloved. Now, if you're familiar with the story of Atraviata, basically the father of Alfredo asks Violeta to leave his son because the daughter or the sister of Alfredo cannot make a good marriage while her brother is living in sin in the country with Partition of Paris society. So Violeta basically falls in deeply in love with Alfredo and chooses to leave him in order to secure the happiness of his family. She makes the ultimate sacrifice. And she returns to the Baron. She returns to the high life that she had left behind. And Alfredo does not know this. And Alfredo, of course, is very hurt and believes that the reason Violeta left him was because he couldn't support her in the way that she is accustomed to being supported. Now, Violeta is sick. She's dying. In fact, when they first met in the party, she had just had a bout of sickness, and she was just coming out after, back into society after being sick for a while. So Alfredo confronts Violeta in a party setting again, and basically Violeta, in order to get Alfredo to believe her, tells him that she is in love with Baron and not in love with him. And so Alfredo, mistaking all that time that he and Violeta spent in the country as time that he now has to pay her for, throws the money in her face and creates a big scandal in the party. Of course, hurts Violeta so much that she is heartbroken and forces the Baron to challenge Alfredo into a duel. So this next scene is already going to be performed by my other cast of Violeta and Alfredo. That's Joan Sia as Violeta and Romeo Peralta as Alfredo. And it's the scene after the confrontation, after the big confrontation, and the fortune teller foresees Violeta's death, and the duel happens, and Violeta is just very, very sick. And it is danced to, again, one of the most famous arias of the opera, Violeta's solo, called
Fenestra.
Yes, thank you.